Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. Now if you're new here, my name is Stephanie and I basically share some awesome golf experiences from all over the place. And you know, I feel like today is going to be a little bit more of an announcement kind of video. I mean, it is also going to be a, you know, like the title says, how I'm preparing for my trip to the Middle East. The whole reason I started my YouTube channel was to promote golf and bring more insight into different cultures of people in different parts of the world. And, you know, I've always, coming from a Middle Eastern background, I've always wanted to bring more light onto the Middle Eastern countries. If you don't know this, so my family's Egyptian, Lebanese, Syrian, and Iraqi. I'm kind of a Mediterranean mutt here. So I'm going to the UAE and Egypt. Now I'm kind of going all over the place in both those countries. I mean, that's the plan. Who knows? Maybe something will get thrown in while we're out there. You never know. This trip is always something I've wanted to do, kind of going back to my roots, and going to Egypt has been, it's a really big deal for me because I've been there before, I've golfed there before, I wrote about it on my website, but you know, now I can do a YouTube video on it and you can get the full experience. And I'm going to be going all over Egypt, you know, not just Cairo, so I'm excited to share that. And I'm just, alright, so now that I've shared that background information with you, I am super excited to start planning out this trip. Because I'm gonna be gone for like 3-4 weeks. Who knows? It might change, you know? Like, what if I'm there and I decide to stay longer? I don't know. But the trip so far is set for 3 weeks, and oh my gosh, what am I gonna do? She's not happy about that. Maybe I just disturbed her from her morning nap. Okay, so after you guys watch this video, if you think anything pops up of what you'd want to see in those two countries, comment them down below. You guys, tell me there is something worse than being 2 weeks out from your trip, your international trip, and then realizing that your passport is gonna expire less than 6 months from your date of travel. And I don't know if you guys knew this, but you know, having a passport, like your passport needs to be valid for 6 months while you're traveling. So, you know, on top of like all the stress that I'm like under right now and like planning everything out and like being in touch with like, with all the different golf courses and tourism companies and whatnot. I could cry, but then that would not get anything done at all, so we're not gonna do that. It's 12 to 16 weeks to get your passport post COVID, but that's because if you're mailing it in. Anyways, obviously I figured I didn't know you could do this, but you can set up an appointment if you have urgent travel within 2 weeks. You can set up an appointment, but it's like they set up the appointment 3 days before your flight. So we'll call tomorrow and hopefully get that squared away. Do some like manifesting as we go to sleep. Yes. Manifesting that good energy. You guys ever do this? Also, like how cute is midnight right now? I'm gonna get you. Hey guys, okay, so I don't know if you know this, but traveling to the Middle East, you know, as a woman, as a female, you know, you gotta be a little bit more conservative. You gotta know what countries, what cities that you need to be dressed a little bit more conservative than others. UAE, I feel like Dubai, which is one of the cities I'll be hitting up, is more lenient, definitely more lenient with dress attire and, you know, more lenient, not as conservative. Like, kind of like, it's just a very international city. There's people from everywhere, so it's... That's funny. Oops. They don't even hang this top. I should cut those off. But, yeah, so the Dubai is not is more lenient, but if you go to like Egypt, like Cairo, you definitely want to cover up more. So I've definitely done some, have been doing some shopping. Online shopping is the way to go with work and whatnot.
So I do this thing where I take pictures of all my outfits that I'm gonna pack because it's easier. Like if I'm on the go, I can just be like, okay, let me see what I have so far, and I'll just like flick through the photos and like, you know, I'll put them like in an album, and I'm just like, oh yeah, like let me see, like is this what I want to wear tonight or nah? I don't know. I mean, maybe it's just me. Hey, how's it going?
Guys, my Arabic's gonna be so good. Oh yeah, I don't know if you guys knew I speak Arabic. I'm thinking of doing half of my vlogs over there in Arabic. Obviously I'll translate into English, but I think that'll be cool to kind of introduce the language and I guess share more, like be more myself. I mean, my culture is a big part of who I am and like why I do what I do, coming from a Middle Eastern background.
Hey. Good morning. Wait, I didn't do my... Wait.
You already know. I wake up ready to go. Ready to go, not golf, but to go get my passport.
Okay, so phew, almost missed that. Almost didn't do that in one of my YouTube videos. So yes, I'm gonna go to San Francisco.
So everything went really smooth, and I'm going to be picking it up today at 3:30. So I have to run and go get my COVID test taken care of, like ASAP. All right, just got my passport appointment finished with. I guess that's just how it goes. Just a no-so-no. Huge, overwhelming emotions of relief. And he's like, you know, if you want, you can pick it up today at 3:30. Bless your heart. Please. Tomorrow's like my last day. I have hella shit to do. And I have hella work to get done before I leave. So, yes. All right. Now it is time to go get that COVID test. Yeah. Gibri, yeah. And then you need the...
Oh, we don't need the scanner.
Oh,
okay.
Okay.
So,
okay.
This lower mask, put my cover,
not expire. Well, I mean, I have the one that expires in January, but my new one as well. Like, whew, like I was stressing out. Like, I was holding back on booking my flights in different parts of Egypt. Like, just going from north to south Egypt. I was holding off on getting those flights, and just because, like, what if my document was wrong? Like, what if something happened? Like, nah, not the business. I need a visa. For, I believe, the UAE and Egypt. But I know Egypt, I can just get it on arrival. I think it's like $25.
like US dollars. And I mean, that's what it was last time I was there. Yeah. Emirates? I don't know if I need a visa. This is like the worst prep with me to go to the Middle East. Let me show you how it's done. It's probably like the worst one, honestly. I'm sorry, guys. I'm tired. I'm lacking sleep. I have been, but that's no excuse. So let's just call it a night. I'm going to organize some of my stuff and then we'll pick back up tomorrow. Hey, what are you doing? Basically how packing goes. Babies are in. Time to go to sleep. Alright, you guys, it is the day. It's so nice and windy out. I'm so sad. Like, since I'm leaving, it's like my favorite type of weather is here, and it's nice and cloudy and overcast and cool, and I just want to snuggle up and like listen to the wind and the rain. But that's okay because I'm gonna be in like 90 degrees heat in the desert. That'll be fun. Okay, so let me know if there's anything specific you guys want to see. Like I said, like I mentioned in the beginning of the video, if there's anything specific you'd want to see while I'm gone, comment it below, because I'm going to be publishing this video today, and I leave today. So I'm going to have like 5 hours at the airport, and I'll publish it then, so right before I leave. I can't believe I'm going. I'm really excited. Okay, I gotta go because we have to be there early. And I will see you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you are so excited, as excited as I am, to see the rest of this series in the Middle East, be sure to hit that subscribe button and stay tuned, because there is much, much more to come. See you in the next one.